what does Christmas mean to me? Well, Christmas has always meant being with family, especially the children. But the real feelings of Christmas start on Christmas Eve, when I enjoy meeting my church family at the Christingle or the midnight service. Now, when I was thinking about past Christmases, I remember for about 25 years, because we didn't want to spend Christmas Day only with one family, my husband and I and the girls would go down to my husband's family for lunch, a lovely Christmas lunch, and then down to my own family for Christmas dinner. And we honestly did that for 25 years, a lot of eating. But on Christmas Day now, and on Boxing Day, we really love having a special time with our own children and, of course, the grandchildren. But unfortunately, this will not be physically possible this year, which is hugely disappointing. However, with the miracle of technology, we will be able to have the joy of seeing the grandchildren opening their presents, which will be absolutely wonderful. So whichever way we are able to celebrate, I truly hope that you will also have that real joy of Christmas with your families this year. Merry Christmas.
Our family, like many in modern times, is fairly far flung. We have members in Hertfordshire in the south, Inverness in the north, and in between others in Kirstorfin, Bathgate, Burnside, Partick, and Motherwell and Wisham. However, this year at Christmas, like most people, we will have to limit ourselves both geographically and numerically. So it's a close family affair this year. Mum and Dad, son from Motherwell, and daughter and son-in-law from Partick, plus their newest addition, Pedro, the Spanish rescue dog from Galicia. So how do we compensate for the reduced scale of our celebration?
In our family, as always, music will play a major part in marking Jesus' birth, even though we will miss the usual musical build-up. John Pitcairthly's Carol Extravaganza at Motherwell Cathedral, the Macmillan musical event in Cadzow, Straven Choral's concert in the Scout Hall, and our own church choir's supporting of the minister leading worship by providing some special music on one of the Sundays in Advent. We do not know whether Pedro is into flamenco or not, but the five humans have varied tastes and the CD player will be white hot, providing background music as we share gifts, enjoy dinner together and relax. Although there will be heavy metal, 80s pop, songs from the musicals, classical and opera, there will also be a large selection of Christmas music by a collection of cathedral and church choirs. When you have almost 2,000 CDs, the issue is what to leave out.
No matter what we leave out, the most important thing is that the six of us are all involved in celebrating this most special day for us Christians. Whatever you decide to do this Christmas Day, we hope you have a lovely time. Happy Christmas.
Christmas means lots of things to me, beautiful memories, happy, happy memories. I remember as a kid growing up in our house, like most houses, with a big sideboard, and the middle of the sideboard was a cocktail cabinet, which throughout the year was filled with the junk we all just still put away to this day, letters that you're going to go back to or posts that you need to deal with, just different day-to-day things. But always knew the anticipation was building up for Christmas when I realised the cocktail cabinet was getting cleared out in preparation for the big day itself. In would come a bottle of Matthias Rosé, a bottle of Warnick's Advocaat for the Snowball, as it was called then, which was Warnick's Advocaat, lemonade, and if you were lucky, a cocktail stick with a maraschino cherry on it. There was also a bottle of Harvey's Bristol Cream Sherry, which was generally for the grannies and grandpas. I have to say, I wasn't really allowed to partake in any of that time, but I've made up for it now, so it just even adds more to my enjoyment of Christmas. Another big part of Christmas, really important to me, because I've always loved music, is the music associated with Christmas, the traditional hymns, but also the modern music. Certainly you never heard it the way you do now in the shops, from virtually from Halloween, Guy Fawkes, all the way through. But I love all that music that is associated with it. I just think it adds to the happiness and the build-up and anticipation, the full enjoyment of the season itself. One particular song that I've always loved, and if you haven't heard it, I would recommend listening to it all the way through. But the words are just so meaningful and just sum up the whole season of Christmas. It's Holy Night by Nat King Cole.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, was born. Oh.